Hi students, let's go ahead with the next module of letter writing. And we have already seen one type of a formal letter, which is a complaint letter. Students, we have seen a complaint letter in which we could develop the second paragraph by writing sentences based on cause, effect, remedy. Now we shall see how to develop a request letter with the same points. Remember students, I told you that even if it is a request letter, we can use the same three points and develop the second paragraph. Let's see how to do that. Let's take a look at the question. Write a letter to the principal requesting. So you can see there it's a request letter to him or her to organize a photography exhibition. So that's your request letter. This is the sample of the answer sheet. And students, the format of the from address, the to address, the subject and the salutation will remain the same. What are we looking at is how to develop the paragraph, especially the second paragraph. Now, the first paragraph also will be a little different because that was a complaint letter and this is a request letter. So let's see how to do that now. Let us look at the main body of the letter. Now, first thing, the first paragraph is an introduction, 2 to 3 lines, and you will say, I, XYZ, am writing this letter to, and you will add the subject. So what is the subject? It's a request. So we can say, I am writing this letter, or you can say, I, the head boy of the school, request for your permission. So you could say writing this letter to request, or directly you can say, I request for your permission. And what is the permission required for? Expand the subject. Here it is, organize a photography exhibition. So your permission to hold a photography exhibition in our school. So that is the purpose of the letter, which you're going to mention in the first paragraph itself. Let us now go on with the second paragraph. Of course, this is the main answer, and you will write about 5 to 6 lines with the help of the three parameters. So the first one, what could be the cause of holding this exhibition? Let us say it is the hobby of the students, and many students are following this now, and therefore probably it is going to benefit them. So you will start with, photography has become a hobby of many of our students. So that's your first line showing the cause of the request. Next one, we're going to talk about the effect. Now, what will happen if this photography exhibition is held? It will give an opportunity to many to learn and to pursue their hobby, and it will also enhance their creativity. So develop the sentences based on that. The photography exhibition will give the students an opportunity to learn and also to create or to become more creative. So here the sentence says, and it will create a new phenomena in creativity. So of course you can develop the sentence in different ways using these points. So this is your second point, that is effect. And finally, when we talk about the remedy, what is the remedy? You want permission to hold this particular exhibition. So here you will say, sir, our plan is to hold the exhibition on Saturday, 29 June. We request your permission to use the school premises. That is the purpose of the letter, the school compound. And we shall also need the assistance of our arts teachers. So here, this is the purpose of the letter. Okay, so we have developed the second paragraph with the three parameters, and now we go on to the third paragraph, that is the conclusion, which is again going to be short, 2 to 3 lines. So here we have an example. It is an earnest request to you to grant us the permission. Simple, or kindly grant us the permission. You can write it in any which ways, but keep it simple. And of course, finally, students, we have the subscription, which is yours truly or yours sincerely. And then remember the comma, and after that, X, Y, Z. Now, students, we have seen both the complaint letter and the request letter. Of course, you also have the third type, that is a suggestion. It is almost like a request. In short, what I'm trying to say is that three parameters, cause, effect, remedy, will help you to develop your formal letter, whatever type it is, whether it's a complaint or a request or a suggestion. So students, we have seen the format of a formal letter in this manner, where we had the from address in the right hand corner, the to address in the left, the subject in the center, the salutation again left, the body of course with three paragraphs, and the subscription. Of course the date comes with the from address. Students, a letter, a formal letter, can also be written completely left-sided in this manner. The from address, the to address, of course, the date coming between them, the from address, I mean, just below the from address, you will write the date line, then you leave a line and write the to address, and then you write the subject, then you write the salutation, the main body, in this case again, it will be all left-sided, and the subscription. So the letter could also be written in this manner. Both are accepted. So students, what we have just seen is the type, that is a formal letter, and how to write a formal letter. In the next module, we shall see another type.